Hello everyone, good morning, good afternoon, depending where you are. I'm Simone Cinotto, the coordinator of the master program, Master of Gastronomy, World Food Cultures and Mobility at the University of Gastronomic Sciences in Polenzo. I've been working at the university for a long time now, and basically, I'm always being involved with the master program. This master program has changed the title over time, but the structure, which I will be talking about in the next few minutes, remain the same. Much, do not say most, or what you hear, what you see in this presentation about this program is basically the product of a process of fine-tuning and updating that have been going on for 15 years now, and one very important factor has been the feedback from the students. With now, again, as you can see and understand, I'm a kind of a old guy now. The students of this in this program at this point amount of several hundreds. Actually, one before actually the discussing, illustrating the program, I must say, and I'm honest to say that the high quality, I would say, of the students in the program, and they're coming from so many different countries. Right now in the program that is concluding now, there are 18 different nationalities represented, so it's very diverse body of students, and also very different backgrounds in very different fields. A BA is required, or equivalent is required to enroll in the course. I mean, again, so very much a diverse crowd. But united, I would say, by the common passion for food and the study of food. I teach at the University of Gastronomic Sciences, Polenzo. I teach modern history. My PhD is actually in US history, and I come from and I came to food studies through my interest in the foodways of immigrants to the United States. I'm talking about a different era because I published my book about that a few years ago now. Most especially Italian migrants to the United States, Italians in the diaspora. So this master program, the young man you see there is a one of my former students from Puerto Rico, by the way, amazing surfer, among many other qualities. This program, let's start with the title, Master of Gastronomy, World Food Cultures and Mobility, is probably a very intensive, as you know, the program is 12 to 13, depends, months long. I would say introduction, very advanced and intensive introduction to the general philosophy and didactic offer of the University of Gastronomic Sciences Polenzo, meaning that with Master of Gastronomy we want to with the idea of gastronomy, we want to reflect the multidisciplinary, interdisciplinary study of food. Food is a thing that touches into every dimensions of the human experience, and as probably what is our in a way the godfather of food studies, this French gastronom of the 19th century, Anselme de Lassavarin, argued needs to be studied, is a very legitimate matter of a serious academic scholarly investigation, and needs to be studied from with the help of methodologies, theories, and approaches from every scholarly field. So with gastronomy, with the study of gastronomy, we want to focus especially on two, I would say, even values that inspire all the work of the University of Gastronomic Sciences Pollenzo, meaning a strong interest in food sustainability, in making our global food system more less taxing to the environment, more respectful to also human landscapes, and basically so to make that we're gonna live a better or at least not a worse planet to the generations after us. And also we are very interested in this notion of food sovereignty, meaning that all human groups deserve as the rights not only of food security, enough safe nutritious food, but also to basically control and regulate the access to so-called culturally appropriate food for them as individuals and as members of communities. What food culture and mobility reflect two other major interests of the university, actually spelled out in the research plan that you can find, by the way, or on the website, the interest for the diversity of food cultures and food systems, and mobility stands for the interest for or the acknowledgement that these food cultures and this food system are created by exchange, trade, and the mobility of the movement of people along with the mobility of food. So the I would say the our title is very representative of what we do at this master program. A little bit of general information, by the way, there are with me, I mean, the idea is for me to talk for 20 minutes maximum. I tend to talk more than needed, so but I'll do my best to be concise today. And then to have a Q&A session. And here with me, there's Ilaria Galvagno from the student office, and she is very knowledgeable about any administrative aspects of the master program, and she will be available to answer your question with me at the end of this short presentation. But anyway, just to wrap it up, the language of instruction for the master program is English. Every proceedings and the classes are all taught in English. When you go on our three study trips, there will be a translation in case it's very very likely chance that you interact with farmers and other food producers in their native language, and you're supposed to write your papers in English. In a word, the language of the program is English, which is the way also you're gonna interact again, like I said at the beginning, with people, with other students, and with faculty, and with let's say st different stakeholders you're gonna meet in a language that everybody can understand and speak. The duration is 12 months. The starting date is March 3rd, 2021. Originally, the program was scheduled to start in October, but for the reasons that you know, for the international public health and travel issues, has been postponed to March 3rd. We are. I would say, I guess I'm anticipating questions about it. We are for now absolutely sure to start on March 3rd. The program this year, because of the situation with COVID, will include a maximum of 20% of online lecturing, and this online lecturing will be concentrated in March and April. Not everything will be a hybrid teaching, but I would say all the online contents that we plan to be online will be concentrated in the first 2 months, and then we expect we really expect that everything will return to quote unquote normal, and everything else will be taught in person, face to face. The end date is March 2022. So basically, the dates, unofficial tentative but not so tentative, should be starting date March 3rd. Classes going through July 23rd. These are tentative dates that I want to give you an idea. And resuming in September 13, and the end of classes will be in October 15. Within this time from March 3rd to October 15, you're gonna take part of participate in three study trips. We're working on the destinations also according to where would be possible to travel to. But again, we remain very much hopeful, and we'll definitely do our best to select, I must say, as we always do, very exciting destinations. And after October 15 through March, you're going to have 4 full months to join, to do an internship. We're going to talk about our internship in a moment, and then return to Pollenzo to graduate. Okay, the return to Pollenzo is actually optional, because if you can do it for any reason, you can have your graduation online. Although we hope that most of you will be able to return in March for graduation. Minimum 70% attendance. Again, this is an intensive program, I'm afraid, and basically classes run from it's like 4 weekday and a half, so let's say from Monday afternoon to Friday, and part of the credits, part of the credit points are earned by attendance, and so this there is this minimum requirement of 70% of classes attended. The total contact hours are around 500. Actually, there are a little more than that. There's also an optional, totally optional Italian course, which adds to this 500 hours. The application deadline, I think this is wrong. I had some wrong. This is an old slide. I think it's December 9th. Ilaria, you remember the deadline for application? Now it's
Yes, the actually September 30 is correct, but we
Oh,
are
for
accepting.
next. Oh, yeah.
Yes,
Sorry.
we are accepting
Oh.
late admission. Yes. So the official application deadline was September 30, but we are still accepting late admission. So you just have to write to Segreteria and you can still do your application process.
Fantastic. Thank you, Laria. The fee is 60,500. We're gonna talk. Actually, I think Ilaria can tell you better about what's available in terms of loans, grants, and we have also a couple different scholarships. But maybe I would leave this to Ilaria. Kate, if you don't mind, since we are recording this presentation, if you don't mind keeping your question for later for the Q&A, unless it's something I think you have to leave. Can I go on? Yes, Kate. Okay. Thank you. So, the Master of Gastronomy, World Food Culture and Mobility is an international master program in food cultures and politics which focuses on critical issues in food studies. Like I said at the beginning, this is supposed to be an advanced and intensive introduction to food studies. Food studies is this, again, with roots in the 19th century at least. But a relatively new field, meaning that got accepted in at least Western academia at the end of the last century, so it's relatively new, and has I mean specific characteristics. One of the reasons why probably is that the time that food study became so relevant and accepted in academia. Is a growing dissatisfaction with the workings of the global food system that emerged very significantly at the end of the last century. Probably also transition from a regime of production that we can call the mass production and mass consumption to one more flexible and I would say shaped by culture and social issues, whatever it is, it is not only about studying food with interdisciplinary perspective and approach, but also I would say, I mean, this is at least what we our philosophy at UNSG and this master program for sure at being aimed. Not so much to elaborate ideas and intellectual cultures in an ivory tower, but making an impact in a way, being political, making a public impact. And also, this is something we also prize very much, is to establish not again, not the academia. The academia talking and the rest of the world, including food producers, farmers, and whatnot, listening, but to establishing a two-way conversation with the world of food production and distribution, and communities, indigenous communities, and so on and so forth. Activism in the dimension of food, and so on and so forth. So this is the kind of food studies basically that we're gonna try and understand and adopt in our understanding of food in the world, and we're gonna do that thanks with the help of some of the best practitioners around in food studies. In fact, much of the many classes in the course, many classes in the program are taught. Some are taught by us, resident faculty of Polenzo, but many more are taught by visiting professors that we invite for the purpose, trying to many of them from very prestigious international universities, by the way, trying to hire you know, scholars that are very 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 prominent, very good, and also very original, and sometimes groundbreaking record in not only teaching but also in research. So definitely there is you know, being a student at the MOG WF CM is also having the opportunity to interact with an international faculty which is chosen among the best full study scholars at an international level. So this is the first thing that this program aims at doing. The second thing is, and you see in the list of courses, there are courses on communication. Try to help students to be good communicator about the knowledge about food that they acquire in the program. So there are, you see now in the list that I think is part of the second, the next slide, there are food writing and food photography courses, but also we understand that being able to communicate about food, about knowing, in terms of knowing about the food products, and we have a number of classes on the history and the technologies and knowledges and testing about some specific products, and also we have a number of practical courses from cooking classes to foraging. And I'm sure I'm forgetting something, but the next slide is supposed to help me in listing the different courses which are part of the program. The program includes hands-on experience, knowledge of food products and transformation practices, and active interaction with global communities of food producers. This is realized, this is achieved mostly on with our three study trips, but also through participation to many to the many extracurricular activities that that happen in Polenzo. From there's a series of conferences. There is the opportunity to join our sustainable farm, the student association. There are many, many opportunities to live the Polenzo experience to the very full. And even if Polenzo is a very small place in a relatively remote area, but with tremendous food and wine, actually, of northwestern Italy, is also very, very much global place with a very significant circulation of students, scholars, experts, activists, protagonists of the no-profit sector as it relates to food, and so on and so forth. So there are many, many opportunities for exciting extracurricular activities. This slide is actually pretty much about what I already said about the diversity of the program, at least in two big dimensions. The diversity of students, which make this program, this is the probably the most international of our master program, which give you the opportunity to interact with people, again, bound by the common interest in food, but coming from different cultures with different experiences, expectations, and so on and so forth. So the bonds that are created while being part of this program really, I mean, can last for a lifetime. And there's a lot of self-learning and self-teaching among students, and also diversity in terms of the faculty body, which is not only made of scholars from very different fields, but also with, you know, coming from different universities and different research projects, and so on and so forth. So this, finally, this is the list of courses. This is what we call survey courses that basically make the infrastructure of the program in terms the introduction to food studies that I've been talking about. So these are food justice activism and advocacy for food sovereignty, food history, food anthropology, food and sustainability, food and public health, agroecology, sustainable farming. This also, now I reminded, this also has a significant practical part. This is a course taught by my colleague Paola Migliorini, which is a agroecology sustainable farming professor. She has a tremendous record, by the way, of getting European Union another source of funding for very much backbreaking research projects. But this course includes visit to local farms, philosophy and environment and sustainability, food communications, communicating about food sustainability and food sovereignty, and food photography. These also are very much hands-on, as you can imagine, hands-on practical courses with a lot of actually making. By the way, if there are 2 minutes at the end, I want to show you actually one project that my students of now almost 2 years ago made that can give you the idea also of multidisciplinarity put in practice. Okay, I'm gonna show you that in 2 minutes. And then there are these courses which are for the most part about the different food cultures and food systems of the world, and this idea of mobility as exchange and food in a world on the move. I don't know if I need to read all of these. I think this information is on the website. Super quickly: Chinese cuisine and food culture, urban food system in India, Southeast Asia, food culture and society in the Ottoman Empire, modern Turkey, sustainable rural development and indigenous community empowerment in East Africa, culinary tradition of Africa, African America, and African diaspora, American Indian cuisine and food culture, traditional knowledge and agrobiodiversity in the Caribbean, new Latin American cuisines, food in the Jewish diaspora, Italian cuisine and food culture, which I teach, sustainable. Oh, okay. Part of my course is a visit to the largest open market in Europe, which happens to be here in Turin. I'm speaking from Turin right now. And so that's part of my course. That visit is a one day field trip plus shopping plus cooking plus dining. Food diplomacy, gastro diplomacy, migrant workers in the global food chain. Very, very quickly, I want to let you. A third. So survey courses, these specialized courses mostly on the world food cultures and food systems. Then there are these courses, I already mentioned them, by the way, in this section called Food Analysis, Tasting, and Cooking Workshop. So with the actual tasting of a number of products, food and foods and drinks, we pretty much rotate the products being studied and being tasted and being appreciated and being assessed and evaluated. This year we have olive oil, cheese, wine, sake, and tea. I already mentioned the foraging. I already mentioned the cooking classes. Here we are. We have. Unfortunately, we are not in Pollenzo right now, but otherwise, I would be happy to give you the campus tour. We have, of course, we have different labs. One of them is a sensory lab, and then we have a cooking lab or our kitchen, where the cooking classes happen. But we want, starting next year, we want more and more connect our farm, which is another of other facilities, our farms. By the way, you'd be very welcome to get involved in the farm itself. The connection between the farm at the table, the farm on the kitchen, so much that some of these cooking classes are taught by our farmer, which is actually ex-student, and the person in charge of our kitchen. So this is a very cool example of classes being taught together by two different faculties. And finally, I think this is very much what characterized our master program, the three steps that I already discussed a bit, and actually 3 to 4 month internship or individual research project. This is an opportunity for you to join companies and businesses, but also no profit foundation and other types of association. Literally, we have, again, we are getting not old, but a young adult. And in this last 15th century, in the last 15 years, we have accumulated, especially not me, our career office, which will be a very important office for you when you're here. They also organize a career week in which different businesses, different companies, different associations come down to Polenzo and basically to meet you, so you can meet them, and they're always available for jobs and again internship opportunities. Anyway, they put together a very large, I would say very rich database of again companies and whatnot, providing even academic institutions, providing many opportunities for interesting internships. If you have other ideas that our database do not cover, or your own contacts, or maybe interacting with in the classroom with some faculty or some visitor, you grasp other ideas for internships, those are also welcome. And again, the career office will work for you to accommodate everything and make hopefully your experience really possibly life-changing, but definitely interesting and rewarding. The very final stage in the master program is your choice: a thesis, which is an academic paper with references, footnotes, and bibliography, the traditional paper, or the other possibility is to write a report on your internship or your individual research project, which is an alternative option to the internship in case you're not interested in the internship. Write about it, both either document will give you the remaining credit points you need to graduate and receive your degree. I think the last part is all for this is the career center approach I was talking about. The last part is mostly administrative, and I will leave to Ilaria to answer your question about that. Just the 3 minutes that I was asking you of your patience to show you this very short clip video. I hope I'll be able to show it, which is basically the making of this project that my students called Food That Moves Us. I gave them this assignment to basically choose a food or a recipe which are important for them in terms of their identity or they were appealed to, and basically reconstruct the history of the itineraries, the global itineraries that the different ingredients made through space and time to end up in that food or in that dish, and also to try and track the historical processes, everything from colonialism, slavery to tourism and religion and whatnot, that shaped those itineraries of food through time and space. So they did that, and they presented with a poster presentation which was incredibly appreciated and praised at an international conference that we had in Pollenzo. There was a UNISG NYU University of Toronto joint conference that we had in Pollenzo in the summer of 2019. It so much time ago, it looks to me like it was, you know, in a different era. Let me see if I can share my screen. I think this is what I need to do. Condividere applicazione schermo. Okay. What is that? Application window. Quick time player. Okay, let's see. Can you see? No. Let me stop it. I'll give it one more try and then I'll pass. I think it's. Okay, so. Condividi file. No. Ho sbagliato. Condivido applicazione. Non so perché. Ok, nothing. Next time. I don't know how to do it. Lei lo sa, Ilaria, perché non vedo.
Ha provato a fare condivisione schermo.
Sì, ma non. Non vedo, condividi. Application window. I see the app, I see the window, but I don't see the. Okay, nothing. Okay. I think we're open for questions. Ilaria, you want to add something that I might have? Davina. Okay, what is your outlook? Oh, sorry. Okay, qua. Davina, what is your outlook or plan for the academic tables resuming lectures, visiting in person, and study trips taking place? Your outlook has been very hopeful, while we can predict a lot of things that will continue to affect travel. Yeah, Davina, you're right. We can. I mean, what we can do is to predict and plan accordingly. Again, The plan is to start with, I mean, to concentrate the online in the very first part of the program, which means the months of March and April, possibly the first week in May, but not beyond that. Again, nobody knows 100% exactly what is going to happen. We can also hope for the better. But in terms of, for example, making our let me put it that way. I mean, even during this last semi-lockdown that is happening in Italy right now, the Italian government has allowed for certain academic activities to continue, and that includes all, let's say, research labs, and including, for example, those activities in the sensory lab, like testing that I was talking about, cooking classes. We've been offering these classes. Even right now, where all other classes are online, of course, with all the required measure of of safety, so the social distancing, the sanification, and the sterilization of everything that is used to do the testings, and so on and so forth. So again, we expect to resume everything in person and with a certain degree of pre-COVID normality by late spring. But even before that, so again, the months of March and April, we look forward to offering most, if not all, of the practical classes. Again, the tasting and the cooking, with the, of course, what we don't want to do is to jeopardize the safety, the well-being, and the health of our students. That's needless to say, not even mentioned. So yeah, I don't know if I answered your question. Maybe another part, since you're talking about the visiting professors. We also are arranging, actually, we had a meeting earlier with Ilari on that. We are arranging the calendar so to be safe in terms of having people, basically professor coming from far away later in the year, so they can still come. So some classes we're gonna schedule in the summer and in the fall, exactly for the reason. So we can pretty much expect this visiting professor to be able to visit. Same thing for the study trips. Okay. But of course, I cannot promise that with the universal vaccination, or almost universal vaccination, we're gonna solve all our problems. I can hope that the best happen, and you can trust me, you can believe me that we're doing everything, I think we're doing everything possible to plan in advance to give you the best experience possible. Priya, thank you for your overview. You're very welcome. After completion of the program, in which sectors organization do students typically work? Could you share a bit? Okay, so again, please contact for the actual figures, which I don't have, both in terms of how our alumni ended up working in that sector, How long it took for them to find a job, please contact the career office. I'm gonna give you the name of the ad, actually, of the career office right here. I'm gonna text it to you. Okay, what I can say in a more narrative way is this. We are not a culinary institute. We're not a cooking school. We do not prepare, and we are not a faculty of agriculture or a food technology department. We provide students, which I must say I'm a very lucky man. Many of them arrive already with an equipment of intelligence, dedication, passion, the brightness that make everything easier. We provide this, I would say very, very, very good overview about the world of food, so they can be interesting human material for many, many companies, businesses, and non-profit associations, from the FAO organization to big and not so big companies. The area where most of them work is or in communication, in sales, in the food politics, or marketing, education. So sectors are very, very, very varied. Something that, again, please contact the career office so you can get the actual figures and numbers. What I can say is that I'm 57, almost 58, so I come from a different labor market and world of work. What I can say that I happen to see my ex-student at least every, many of them, not all of them, every 2 years when in Turin there is this big convention of farmers called Terra Madre, and the other twin global event, Salone del Gusto, the Taste of Fair. And we have a space as a university, and I meet there so many of my former students. And sometime they have, they give me this impression to having found jobs, sometimes the jobs of their dreams in so different sectors. Sometimes I'm very amazed. They talk to me. They explain to me about jobs that I didn't even know they existed. So what I think we do, it is certainly what we try to do, is to provide our student with a knowledge so deep and so broad also, they can appeal many employers. Then some of them, by the way, also start their own business. I have many, many examples that I could make. Allora, Davina, wondering about lecture visiting chefs. Fantastic, I think I answered. Agnes, about the internship, has to be in Italy or can be in any country? No, it can be absolutely anywhere. In the last two years, I remember, thanks to one of our faculty, actually, Luciana Bianchi of which is the instructor for the new Latin American cuisines course class, which has started a program in marine ocean sustainability in the Galapagos Islands. I think a total four of our students went to the Galapagos which I am very jealous of. So no, anyway, Davina, Ilaria Galvagno, career. Okay, Priya, very thank you. If there are other questions, but if Ilaria wants to say something, please. I'm sure I forgot something important. So if you want.
I just want to leave in the chat the email address of segreteria@unisg.it, which is the email address of the register office. So if you want to applicate for this program, we are still accepting late admission. So please get in touch with segreteria and you will get all the information about the application procedure. So please take note of this important email address. If you have any other questions, we are here.
I don't know why. Devo far ripartire questo programma. Yes, I was trying to again to run the video, but I can do it. Yes, I don't know if there's no other question. Yes, I would call it. Let me give you also my email. You can email me. I don't know if you want this. If you want this PDF presentation, I'll be happy to send it to you. Any question, I will be happy to answer. Maybe Ilaria, you want to say something about the loans and the scholarship?
Yes, there is one total fee exemption available from UNESG. Of course, so this will cover all the fee, and you will have included also an accommodation during the program, and you can apply for the scholarship writing to my colleague Manuela Barra. I will leave you her email address here. Okay. And yes, there are of course some requirements. For example, you have to be from low-income countries. You have to have minimum level of English of C1 and obtain a minimal score of 80 out of 100 in the application process, in the application evaluation. So these are the main three requirements you have to meet in order to obtain the scholarship. Yes, if you want to try to apply for that, please write to my colleague Manuela. She is in charge of giving all the information about scholarship. She's also available for calls and video calls and so on.
Okay,
It's just answering. Yeah, okay, Simone, you already answered to Davina. Okay, perfect. Thank you.
Oh yeah, Althea asked about the loans. You remember something about loans?
Yes, I think there are also, if I remember well, there are also loans, as for example, for students from United States, the Fulbright, as Lucia mentioned before, and also there are some other loans for Italian students. You can ask further details also to Manuela Barra. She will give you further details on that.
No problem,
You're
Althea.
welcome.
Okay, if there's, again, there's nothing else, Agnes, thank you, Simone. See you on the March. Oh, Agnes, this is good news. Very much looking forward to meeting you. Great. Priya, fantastic, fantastic. Okay. By the way, I'm very, very excited about starting in March. Now we've been delayed for some months now, and after all this lockdown, I mean, as you may know, I mean, Italy started it for everybody else in Europe, so. It's been a long story with the coronavirus, and I really look forward to March, and the program starts really very much. Althea, I'm graduating this summer. Will be the next program then start in October? Yes. The next program will gonna start in October 2021. When this program ends. Yes. Okay, fantastic. So I'll see you soon, and have a great rest of your day. Again, if you want any kind of clarification or answer to any question, email me, email Ilaria. And in terms of the job opportunities and our record in placement, email the career office. Okay? You all take care, okay? Thank you, Lucia. Fantastic. Likewise, very nice meeting you. Keep studying Italian, okay? So
Certo.
Allora, arrivederci a presto allora. Lucia, stai bene?
Grazie, arrivederci.
Piacere di averti incontrato.
Bye
Bye.
bye.
Thank you everyone. Thank you.